Let me turn one of the things when we see you on television and we read your books and we hear all about your interviews. One of the things, those may have been your first days of being paid, but if I may just quote from 1960 to 1963, you won 29 titles. Unbelievable accomplishment. And during that same period, Mr. Palmer, one could argue that the purses that you won, by today's standards, would be minute. How do you feel? What if you were winning in 4 years 29 titles in this century? How do you feel about the athletes today earning at these levels that we see on television?
Well, I'm happy for them to start with, and that was part of my goal when I turned professional in 1954. My ambition was to succeed, number one, to be a good player and to win golf tournaments. And whether it was the National Open or the Citrus Open, as far as I was concerned, it was the same. To beat the guys that I had to beat to win was important to me. And one of the goals that I had was to elevate the game of golf to whatever stature you can say what it is today, what it was in the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, so on. The thing that one of my goals, other than just winning, was to bring it to a standard that people recognized the standard that we were playing in. And when you think about it, and of course it gives me an opportunity right now to just say, 30 years ago, I moved the Citrus Open to Bay Hill, and the prize money for that first tournament here in 1979 was $100,000. In 2008, the prize money will be $5.5 million. Is that correct? $5.8 million. So that's 30 years, and you can think what has happened. And I feel some reasonable success in the fact that it is $5.8 million. Where I probably have a little regret is that some of the people that are playing the game today are not as appreciative of the fact that it was 100,000 30 years ago and it is almost 6 million now. I would like to see a little different reaction from the players and as to what has happened in 30 years. That doesn't mean that they're not good guys. They're all great guys and they're great players. Some of them just don't have enough time to go back and look at what it was when it started. And I would like to see them take a little more time and just understand so they can appreciate what has happened in 30 years.